everyone, this is Garrett, and this is Painkiller, and we are going into Chapter 3, Level 2, The Abandoned Factory. And we start off in this, what looks like a server room of some kind, and it has some PCs, and it has a thing running on it, and I don't know what it is, but it looks pretty exciting, and it runs on every single PC. Now, the card unlocking thing is kill at least 30 enemies in demon morph mode. And this is kind of an odd one because apparently in older versions of the game, you had to do this in a single charge of demon mode. Also, there's an armor behind here. But in the version I'm playing, which is just the latest version, you don't. you just kill 30 in total out of every one of your demon mode things. So it's a little bit easier for me, but fortunately, the very last part of the level has an area where you can just very easily get a whole bunch of kills in demon mode because there's that many enemies just at the end. So there's really not much to worry about. Also, our soul catcher silver card is working quite well. That soul was behind that pipe and I didn't need to walk over it to pick it up, and that is very nice. Makes getting all those souls just a little bit easier. Also, right now, we don't really have a whole lot of ammo. This is actually one of the few stages where we don't have that great amount of ammo. The ammo is sort of not really hidden, but it's just hard to see sometimes, which might make it a little bit scary in terms of the ammo situation, but we should probably be fine. I do want to collect as many souls as possible. We do have our demon mode at 50 souls card turned on right now, and of course our soul catcher card as well, and the combination of these two things is going to get us a lot of demon modes during this level. It's very lovely, and it's gonna be great. Now, just gonna just kill everyone here. Fortunately, these guys don't deal a whole bunch of damage. They jump around every now and then, but it doesn't really seem to do anything other than move them forward slightly. They're not actually very good at moving, jumping on top of me, and I'm not even sure if that even does anything in particular. And of course, unlike in the previous level, we can actually pick up souls now. In fact, we have to pick up souls to get into demon mode, so we have a nice amount of healing working in our favor in this level, and not much to worry about at all, which is very nice. Sadly, our Soul Keeper card is not active right now, so souls do disappear pretty quickly, but we should still be fine. There's like 300 something enemies in this level, so it's not like we're gonna run out of enemies to kill. And just gonna finish up the remaining enemies in this place before moving on to the next area. Did that guy die? Yeah, he did. And it is oddly satisfying to shoot them while they're in the air, especially with this gun. But pretty much everything works against these guys. They're really not very strong at all. Also, some more secondary fire for our shotgun, which is going to make life a little bit nicer. And where is that last guy? He's probably on top of this thing, maybe. Yeah, he is. He's just hiding for some reason. And he's jumping off, so he's no longer hiding, I suppose. Very nice. And that was the last enemy. Now, there is a secret, actually, pretty close to this place. You can technically use these things to just painkiller jump there, but they disappear so quickly that it's virtually impossible. One way to do it is by moving the box all the way there. I don't really like doing that because it takes a while and it's just not very exciting. But there is another way. Well, technically there are two other ways, but I haven't actually figured out how to do one of the other two ways, which is there are these things hanging from the ceiling, these weird hook things. And people claim that you can shoot them off and then use them for painkiller jumps, but I have not managed. And I've tried with these boxes as well, but they just make you fly into the air really quickly for some reason. They don't really function very well as just normal boxes, and pushing them anywhere is a nightmare. And that guy's shooting me with a flat gun or some kind. And it's kind of an annoying secret. The only thing you get out of it is a single ammo box as well, so it is just kind of tedious. And you know, I just want to get all secrets, so we're just going to have to deal with the tediousness of what it is and just go with it. We only have two stakes right now, which is not great, but oh well, we should be fine. I think there are actually some stakes inside this building, and there's a whole bunch of rocket launcher ammo there as well, so we could actually just switch to this and use our machine gun, because that actually works quite well as well. Here's some more shotgun ammo over there. Quite a bit more, and here are the stakes I was looking for. So our ammo is looking quite nice, so it's not too much of a problem. And can I grab that before it disappears? Yes, I can. Very nice. So the secret that I was talking about, it's on the right over here. It is where those guys are standing. And Yeah, there's an ammo box. You may have seen it. It was very, very briefly on screen, but it's just right there. Just take my word for it. You'll see it in a second. And people have claimed that you can shoot these things just with the rocket launcher and they'll fall off, but I've never seen them fall off. At least not in these ones. There are ones later in the level which do fall off, but these particular ones seem pretty stubborn when it comes to actually falling off the thing. Now, the problem with me getting the secret is that I'm gonna have to do a jump, so I'm probably just gonna try it once, and if I fail, then I'm just gonna video edit to the part where I actually do get to jump. But let's give it a shot. Whoop. And because the jump is kind of fiddly, as you can see, and it requires you to jump from that to that right there. So it's a little bit tricky, but let's see if we can do it with the magic of video editing. There we go. It took a while, but we got it in the end, and we picked up our ammo, which is great. Now, as I said before, another way that you can do it is by just moving this box to that particular location, and eventually it'll move, and using the magic of physics, it is just not cooperating right now, but usually it'll actually move when you hit it like this and run into it a little bit, but for some reason, its speed is a little bit limited. But that's also one of the reasons why I couldn't really be bothered to do it that way. But when it's up against the wall, you just run into it while jumping, and somehow, sometimes you just magically fly up really high into the sky, sort of like this. And that should get you on top of there as well. I just prefer to do it the jumping way, because it looks ever so slightly cooler. And I've already done the thing with the box in the prison level, so I don't want to do it again. Okay. So moving on, I'm just going to save the game, and we go in here, and these boxes open, and there's an enemy inside, a whole bunch of them, and they're pretty scary. There's also enemies behind me right now, which are also a little bit scary, but I'm going to grab these guys' souls, and then I'll focus on those guys. They're trying to jump on my face, but they're not doing a very good job. Also, there's ammo over here for the electricity gun, which I might as well use, because why not? It's a weapon we have ammo for, and it actually works fairly decently against these guys. They need like 2 shotgun shots. Or a single stake from the stake gun works pretty well as well. But we might as well just use every weapon we got, because then we don't have to worry about our ammo situation quite as much. And we're about to go into demon mode in a second. Oh, apparently we are going into demon mode now. Wasn't really prepared for that, but sure, I'll go with it and just run, jump, kill everything. This might be a little bit hard to see because even on my screen it's a little blurry right now, and I can't imagine what YouTube is going to do to this. So just pretend that there's a whole bunch of red things and a whole bunch of white things, and the red things are dying. Basically, that's what happened just now. And I'm actually going to jump all the way back to collect a whole bunch of souls, collect a whole bunch of money that came from all those things we just destroyed, pick up some ammo on the way as well, because there's actually a fair amount of ammo lying all over this place. Because of demon mode, you won't really see much of it, just because you're kind of forced to just jump forward as quickly as possible there if you want to get as many kills as possible with that particular instance of demon mode right there. And don't really have to worry about health all that much, actually. For some reason, these enemies don't seem to deal that much damage, which is quite nice. And, you know, there's that many enemies that we can just grab every soul. The armor is probably just really helping out in this particular area as well. Oh, man, he got stuck to that. That was actually pretty sweet. And, yeah, the combination of just getting a lot of different armor power-ups and so many souls just all the time everywhere, it really just helped you just stay alive, which is very nice. And the moment we kill all that stuff here, eventually stuff's gonna jump over. These guys are a little bit annoying. They have 2 guns and they try to sort of jump out of your way a lot, which is a little bit tedious, but they do die very quickly from our secondary fire and our shotgun primary fire combined with each other to make a destructible mess out of everything. And I'm just gonna grab all these souls. I wanna get as many demon mode opportunities as possible. And it doesn't really matter what we do, because we're pretty much bound to get the thingy anyway, the tarot card at the end. I'm actually running out of shotgun ammo here, so I'm actually just going to switch to this gun, because that works fairly well against these guys as well. I believe there is actually some shotgun ammo coming up ahead. It might actually be here as well. No, there's just stakes here. And machine gun ammo, which is also good, of course. So might as well just use some of that. We have 285 bullets for this thing, but this thing does shoot a lot of bullets in a short period of time, as a minigun or machine gun or whatever it is often does. Now these hooks, sometimes they will just come off by themselves, and I'm not really sure why, but it just sort of happens. And other times you're actually going to have to shoot them with the rocket launcher, which actually works quite well as well. You just hit it from as high as possible with your rockets, and usually they'll just detach from the ceiling immediately. and I took some damage that I didn't really want to take. That guy exploded pretty close to me, and it hurt a lot, and that one hurt as well. So I'm actually going to have to be a little bit more careful here, because I'm just being a little bit silly right now. And I'm just going to grab as many souls as I can before moving on. I'm not actually sure. I think there's a whole bunch of ammo here, but I'm not actually sure if there's any health power-ups anywhere nearby, but it would be nice. There is some ammo coming up, which is also good, and I believe there's actually another hook somewhere over here as well. That thing just came off somehow. Not really sure why. It just happened. And speaking of those things coming off, I was actually looking for the other hook because it's usually... Oh, there it is. It's a little bit closer to the wall where I need to go up. Also, there's some shotgun ammo over here. But there's a secret area over here as well, and I want to grab that as quickly as possible. Now, as you saw, that thing just flew up for some reason, but if you shoot it, usually they'll come off by themselves. Sometimes that thing flies really high into the sky, but it disappears shortly afterwards. Now, that one only has fire in it, but that one, I guess I do actually need to use a rocket there. There we go. That one doesn't have fire in it. I guess the fire makes it more likely to explode or something if you shoot it. But using that thing, we shoot it behind us, and then we put it in the position again and pretend that that never actually happened. I wonder actually if it might just be good enough to just have it lying there. Yeah, it is. So you can just jump on top of this, and there's a holy item inside that thing for some reason. Not really sure why, but it's just something we're gonna have to deal with. And I'm actually gonna take this thing with us because we're gonna need this to get a secret a little bit later on. I don't know if there's another way of getting that secret either, so might as well just take this thing with us immediately because it gives us an armor power-up, and I want those right now because our armor is a little bit bad right now, to be perfectly honest. And a whole bunch of people spawn in this area as well. A whole bunch of these guys. Some of them somehow died, which I'm not really sure how that works, but sure. And I'm going to go into demon mode right here because my health is not great, and there's a lot of these guys over here, which is definitely going to help our kill count in terms of demon mode kills. And there's a bunch over there as well on top of those, whatever they are, oil drums, I guess. And might as well shoot these guys as well. These guys actually do a fair amount of damage as well, so getting them out of the way as quickly as possible is quite nice. And I'm just going to kill all these guys, steal their souls. We might actually already be at the 30 soul mark, really, but the thing is, it doesn't really indicate it very well. Usually, you only get to know if you did the tarot card requirement after you've actually beaten the level. So it would be a little bit unfortunate if we reach the end and then it just says card status failed. But I guess we'll see that when we get there. And these guys are being annoying to me right now. It's not very nice. At this point, we might actually want to use our tarot cards at some point. I'm not really planning on using the tarot cards in a really specific location in this level because there aren't just a lot of areas with a lot of enemies inside them, but usually we can go to demon mode in the especially scary areas. Now, at this point, the music is still playing, but we can actually just wander around for a while, and I'm actually going to take that opportunity to take this thing to that direction. Because there are two oil drums over there. One has a ladder next to it, and one doesn't. And the one without the ladder next to it is the one where we're going to have to jump on top of it. And I'm actually just going to put this over here. This should actually be good enough, probably. Because I'm going to jump on those pipes. And from those pipes, generally speaking, you can jump on top of that oil drum. It might actually be a little bit easier to just place this thing close to the oil drum itself. But, eh. This will probably work just fine. Usually it does, but again, our jumping shenanigans are not going too great during this playthrough. So I'm just going to have to improvise a little bit. Just talk a whole bunch of talking while I put this thing back in its original location. I wonder if it's even possible, actually, to put it right next to the oil drum. It probably is, but usually this works. So let's just do this, jump on the side, and grab an armor power-up. And that puts us back at 200 armor. That is actually a really useful power-up right there. And having grabbed that, I'm going to go inside here because this is where the next enemy spawn is. And it's filled with a whole bunch of nasty more of those flamethrower guys which explode when you kill them. Again, you don't want to stand next to that explosion. I've said that so many times already, but I keep saying it because it is valuable information. You don't want to get destroyed here. And killing those four guys or something opens up a door outside. You can actually grab another armor over here, but I don't think it's as good as the armor we have right now. And because we're already at such high armor, we can't even pick it up right now. So, you know, it's nice to have that the secret armor rather than this one. But if you are somehow running out of armor going outside here, then there's another armor power-up waiting for you there. Now, this door opens the moment we go to that checkpoint and walk back outside. Just gonna kill these guys with a rocket launcher because they do die very quickly to explosions, which is very nice. Gonna grab a whole bunch of their souls and make it a little bit easier to get into the emote later. Our health is already looking a little bit better. There's actually a health bar up inside that building as well, so we can grab that the moment we're done here. But given the amount of enemies there are, actually are here, there's just plenty of souls to pick up here, so it's fine. I believe there's actually going to be enemies jumping out of that window soon. Oh, shoot. Hopefully there's enemies jumping out of this window, because otherwise I've wasted demon mode. I think I just have. Oh, well. That's a little bit unfortunate, but it's not the end of the world, so I'm just not going to worry about it. I'm just going to let this end as well, actually. I might as well just go over here, because there's some ammo over here I can pick up, I believe. Yeah, there is. Oh, maybe I already did. No, there it is. I'm just confusing myself right now. So, yes, I was going to go inside the little building, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. It's a little bit hard to see when you're in demon mode, but for some reason, this is a secret area, and it has a holy item in it as well. Even though there's a whole bunch of enemies swarming outside this building, and I believe you actually need to go inside this building as well at one point, but for some reason, that holy item is a secret area. And having grabbed that, we can move on to the next location. There's two of these destructible things, which are not immediately obvious you can destroy them, but here they are, and they actually blow up a hole in the wall right there. And if you wait a while, they'll just explode by themselves, so if you're really stuck, then eventually you'll just see something, this thing explode, and you'll be like, oh, what's that? And then you see this hole in the wall. The thing is, though, I believe there's other ways of getting inside this building, and the problem with that is the spawn trigger is over here. So, even if you get into this building through other ways, the enemies just won't spawn, and you just have nothing to do here, which is kind of silly in my opinion, but what are you gonna do? This game is really old. And, anyway, we're just gonna focus on killing these enemies which are hanging out over here. Might as well use this gun for a change, because we have plenty of ammo for it. They don't, these guys take a fair amount of damage as well, and they look really cool when they get killed by shocking, because they move all over the place afterwards when they die, which is kind of hilarious. Because apparently that's how electricity works, and that is pretty neat. And there's a whole bunch of ammo downstairs here as well, which is one of the main reasons why I'm actually still downstairs. But to be fair, there's actually quite a lot of ammo just inside this building overall. So odds are you're not going to be running out of ammo anytime soon here. Now, these guys are having some trouble actually hitting me for some reason. Those guys are of the variety that I just sort of run around aimlessly for long periods of time and don't really seem to do anything, which is more of a bother to me than to them, unfortunately. Like, they won't kill me, but they're not going to kill me anyway, so like, it's more just a nuisance that they're hard to hit because they move around so much. And we're just going to kill our way through this building, I believe. I thought there was ammo here, but I guess I'm just wrong. Just flat out wrong. So I'm just going to move forward. There's a guy outside. These guys are actually quite strong as well, because some of them take two shots from the state gun. Not all of them for some reason, but some of them do. Maybe that it does actually depend on where you shoot them, but who knows. Either way, we're just gonna kill stuff. There is still an arrow pointing inside the building, I believe, so I'm actually just gonna check out where my compass is pointing to, because we do have to kill everything before we can move on. So there we go. There's one more enemy over there. And I'm not even gonna bother waiting for his soul. I'm just gonna move on, which is in this direction, where the next checkpoint is, and a staircase going upwards, and an enemy! One enemy. Not really sure why that guy warrants an entire checkpoint by himself, but I guess maybe they need a single enemy at least to spawn another checkpoint or something? I don't know. Either way, there's a whole bunch of enemies here. If you hit these guys correctly, they explode, and then their ragdoll looks like that. Like that. Like, they just don't move at all. It looks really strange, but they are in fact dead, even though they're not moving at all. And it's kind of hilarious to me, but what are you gonna do? Physics are hard, especially in those days, but even current day technology is still not very great at physics a lot of the time, so what are you gonna do? That was 2004 that this game came out. So preferably in this area, I would have liked a little bit more souls, so I would have gotten demon mode a little bit quicker. But given that there is so much ammo and that our health and armor situation is pretty much fantastic, to be perfectly honest, we don't really have much to worry about. Because it's mostly just tedious, this particular area. That door closes the moment you get close to it, and then all these guys spawn. And all of these guys don't really deal a whole bunch of damage, and they die really quickly, so it's not really a problem. But it's more just that demon mode just takes care of them a lot quicker than the methods I have otherwise available. So I'm just going to have to shoot them a lot and grab their souls. Maybe I can still get a demon mode in there. a little bit late into the battle, but it would be a little bit useful, but not greatly. Because the thing is, the strongest enemies actually spawn at the end of this particular gauntlet over here, so getting it near the end is actually not that bad at all. It's actually kind of helpful, probably more helpful than my reasoning for getting it now, because my reasoning for getting it now is just that it's a little bit quicker, really. And we are nearly there. I'm actually not gonna... Okay, there we go. We're nearing the strong enemies now, which is these guys. And I want to have the MMO for these guys because it just makes it a lot less scary. These guys still explode when you kill them. And I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. Is there still one alive? No. So I guess it's just taking a while before the next batch spawns, maybe. Maybe there's another batch which I was thinking of, which I thought were the stronger enemies. And there we go. Yep, there is a second batch of these guys. That's a little bit unfortunate. But again, our secondary fire of the shotgun takes care of these guys very quickly. A lot quicker than most other weapons, because they tend to go into this weird posing mode where they just barely take any damage at all a lot of the times from our stake gun. Like, the stake gun is pretty much useless against these guys because you need to shoot them so many times. This actually works quite well, like, surprisingly well. I didn't think the minigun actually worked that well against those guys, so I learned a thing while recording, and that's quite nice. Now, that way leads to a dead end, and you can actually see the dead end over here. And you can see that particular door. Now, you're going to see that door a little bit later as well, and that's why it's relevant. So we move a little bit further, just bunny up our way through this building right here. And you see in the far off distance, you see that same door. It probably doesn't mean anything, but it sort of does for this particular instance, which is that when we shoot it for a while, I'm actually going to grab these guys' souls because I do want to have some souls for the next area as well. This is what I mean. Like, this is what usually happens, where they just sit there and just sort of not die for a long period of time. But those doors just opened, and that means, for some reason, that the doors we saw previously opened as well. A lot of guides online say, like, you need to kill all the enemies at the level so the level exit opens and then you can get this. But it's just wrong. Maybe in older versions of the game that was actually the case, but in the newest version this actually opens the moment you kill those guys. And I always thought it was a bit weird that it wouldn't open until you kill all the enemies, considering the only thing in here is ammo and armor. So there you go. But we move on a little bit further forward. Our armor is at 200. Our health is not bad at all. And speaking of our health, it's actually going to be a little bit better in just a moment, because there's another 100 health power waiting for us right there, and a whole bunch of ammo. And there is actually another secret area which we can get over here before we start off the last battle of this level, which is right here. But we can actually just bunny hop. We can actually just bunny hop to there. And from here, there is a ladder which we can get onto, which leads to a secret area. It is actually possible to get the secret area later on, after you fought the last battle, but it would be a little bit pointless. There is something up here which is only temporarily good, which is not that holy item, but it's this giant skull which is hanging out here. I believe this is a damage power-up. It's really not great at dealing extra damage. It's not like quad damage, like in Quake and stuff like that. It's just, you get a little bit of extra damage. And there's two ways of leaving this area. There's a whole bunch of invisible walls surrounding this place for some reason, and if you just jump for a while, like properly here, then eventually it should actually just let you up. And it's just not working. It's just like all jumping things today, and with this entire playthrough, usually this thing would allow you to just get back up by just jumping like this, but for some reason during this entire playthrough, I can only imagine that there are some frame rate related things here, because this isn't that hard. This should just usually, if you just mash the jump button up here, it should usually just get you back up here without any issues at all. But for some reason, it's just take my word for it. Normally speaking, this is how you would just get up. You could just take the ladder down again, but for some reason, jumping is just not, it's just not intended for this playthrough or something. Like, jumping is just out of the question entirely for this entire playthrough, and nothing is working in that sense anymore. But just take my word for it, you guys. Normally, if you just mash the jump button against this thing, you'll just somehow magically hit that ladder again, and then, yeah. But not in this playthrough, I guess. Now, another way of going down here, I figured I might as well just load the game, because we didn't really get to use our damage power-up, is to just jump down here. There's a whole bunch of holes there. It'll do some damage, Quite a lot of damage, actually. But it's fine. And going here spawns these guys. They're just a whole bunch of normal dudes, but they do instantly explode the moment we hit them with this. Even these guys don't take that much damage anymore, which is very nice. But unfortunately, the damage power-up only lasts for a very short period of time. Right now, the thing is still surrounding our screen, so it means it's still active. But any second now, the redness will disappear, and that just means that this power-up is over. And there it goes. We actually lost all of our armor jumping down, which is a little bit annoying. And that guy was strong for some reason. And this is the area I was talking about in terms of just having a lot of different enemies which we can very easily kill. And gives us a lot of demon mode kills once we actually get to demon mode. Even having killed all these guys, I should probably still be fine. Even if we didn't have the latest version of the game and therefore would actually need to kill them all in one single charge. Because the moment we kill all these guys, it starts spawning a bunch of enemies from the container to the right over here. And the moment we start killing these guys, it actually starts spawning even more enemies out of this container as well. And as you can see, there's just so much stuff over here. You can actually see it from the kill counter at the end, after this demon mode, that how many enemies I killed. And just sort of from the souls as well, really. But it should probably amount to at least 30. And if it didn't, then wouldn't matter, because we're playing on a latest version anyway, so who cares? But just killing off these remaining stragglers over here. There's still a bunch of the slightly stronger variety enemies spawning as well, which is those flamethrower. Well, not even flamethrower dudes, just the guys with the pistols, who are slightly annoying, but they're all pretty weak to missiles at the same time, so it doesn't really matter too much. And we still have 500 bullets for this thing as well, so in the end, we're gonna be just fine. And the sound plays, indicating that we have opened the level exit, and we've picked up everything that I want to pick up as well. So I'm just gonna climb up this unnecessarily long ladder onto the level exit, and there we go. Pretty long level, mostly because I just completely failed at jumping as per usual during this entire playthrough. And we missed a whole bunch of destructible objects, but who cares? And who cares about all that other stuff? There was one armor we missed, but that was only because we couldn't pick it up. But at least we apparently kill at least 30 enemies while in Demon Morph mode. And the status is unlocked, and it is Forgiveness. You can use golden cards 2 times per level. It has its uses, and maybe for the next level I'll choose to equip it, but for now I'm more like, eh, I don't really need it. But maybe I'll change my mind when I start recording level 3 of chapter 3, the military base. But we'll see that next time. Bye-bye.